What up? It's Jimmy from odds.com. This is a clip from our big NCAA basketball show. To check out the entire show, hit the link at the bottom of the screen. It's available exclusively on odds.com. Michigan State at Rutgers. Spartans, Scarlet Knights. Rutgers opening up as 2.5-point favorites. That is 3 now at a couple books. This total opening up at 143. It's dropping fast. And it's all over the map. We have 142, 141.5, 141, and a 140.5 has hit the board. We're at Rutgers Athletic Center in Piscataway, New Jersey. Michigan State 8-4, 2-4 in the Big Ten. Rutgers 8-6, 4-6 in the Big Ten. We'll start with Michigan State. Because of COVID issues in the program, Michigan State hasn't played since snapping their two-game winning streak in a 55-54 loss at home to Purdue way back on January 8th. All rotation pieces will be back for sure, except for fourth leading scorer, guard Joshua Langford, who's been upgraded to questionable. I don't know if you have more information on that, Max. The Spartans have two players scoring in double digits in forwards, Aaron Henry and Joey Hauser. They score 76 points per game, get nice distribution, 19.2 assists per game, hit 44.8% from the field, 34.7% from three, and 76.6% from the stripe. Rutgers snapped their five-game losing streak with a big 74-70 win at Indiana on Sunday. Senior guard Geo Baker went for 19 points, 5 assists in the win. He's averaging 9.6 points, 2.8 assists on the season. So it was a huge, huge uptick in production from senior guard Geo Baker. Leading scorer, junior Ron Harper Jr., had another big game going for 15 points and 12 boards, 6'6", very athletic. Averaging 18.3 points, 6.5 boards on the season. 6'11 junior Miles Johnson, a very important piece. Nice night for him as well in the win over Indiana. 8 points, 8 boards, 5 blocks. He's averaging 8.1 points, 8.6 boards on the season. They hit 46.2% from the field, 35.4% from three, but struggle badly at the line, hitting just 57.9%. Max, Big Ten action, Michigan State, Rutgers, Scarlet Knights. Let's roll.
If there was ever a case for some revenge-itis, I think that this would be the spot, Jim. When I watched, and don't forget, I was on Rutgers, and I was on the over in that game, that they just got dumbfounded. It was like someone roofied them and took advantage of them for a couple hours and then sent them outside with their pants around their ankles. So I think that with this Steve Pikel team this year, we just haven't seen the same team that we saw last year. It is a similar roster. We have seen development from Miles Johnson. We have seen Ron Harper Jr. take that step forward. And we've seen Geo Baker being the consistent Dwayne Wade-type player that he aspires to be. I think that with Rutgers, this is a team that definitely has to snap the next streak that they have to deal with is their home losing streak, where you've lost to Iowa, Wisconsin, Ohio State, all in tough games, all games that stayed under the number. I think that with this Rutgers team, the expectations have to be low. But in this circumstance, in this particular matchup, with these COVID protocols affecting Michigan State, I think that you have to look at Rutgers if you can get 3 and under. And if you can get me 2.5, Jim, I'll take Rutgers in this spot. I think that with Rutgers, we did see the change in starting lineup, putting a struggling Montez Mathis on the bench, and also relegating Jacob Young. While Jacob Young definitely is probably your best free throw shooter and the guy that you're going to have on in the fourth quarter, in the second half, forgot what sport I'm talking about. And I don't think it's real important for him to be starting. I think it's real important for him to be finishing. And we've seen in games that Rutgers have played well, specifically the Purdue game, he had the ball in his hand. He was driving to the bucket, and he was getting to the free throw line and converting. I think with this Rutgers team, they have now Caleb McConnell back in the lineup. I think that just gives you another offensive weapon that can guard multiple positions and be an asset all over the floor for you. I think that when you look at this Rutgers team on paper, they should be better. This is the time of year that teams start to find their groove. If they are going to have a groove, I'm counting on Rutgers finding and having their groove and dishing out a little bit of cold cock soup to Michigan State. So I'll take Rutgers at 2.5 if I can get it. And with the total, this is a spot where a lot of Rutgers games, I like lines between 143 and 147.5. And with the number as it is, there isn't 2.5 points of value to get me on it one way or another. I'm definitely going to be watching this line and tracking it throughout the night and hopefully getting a better number one way or another.
Well, Max, we have good news. All the books have their 2.5s juiced, except for Circa. Circa is giving you that 2.5 at minus 110, so we're locking that in. Max, getting his night started with the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, minus 2.5 at minus 110 in Piscataway, New Jersey. Big Ten action starts Max's card.